Hello, Cloud Gurus. I'm Nigel Poulton, the author of the Kubernetes book, and welcome to Kubernetes This Month. As always, we'll get you up to speed with what's been going down in the Kubernetes world in this last month, and we'll pick a couple of things and go into a deeper dive. Then we'll round things out with a chance for you to test your Kubernetes knowledge with a brand new Guru of the Month question. First up this month, and this is a big one, Kubernetes 1.19 is here, and it is about time. Well, obviously, we'll take a proper look at that in the deeper dive section. Into the other news though, Portainer, the popular UI for managing your Docker stuff, got a 2.0 release, and it now supports Kubernetes. Istio got a 1.7 release. OpenShift virtualization is now at 2.4. So this is a feature of the OpenShift container platform, which now lets you run containers, serverless, and now VMs shoulder to shoulder on a single platform. Congratulations to the folks behind K3S. That's the lightweight Kubernetes distro for the edge or for IoT. They have been accepted into the CNCF as a sandbox project. Hopefully, this will help it power forward and benefit from the governance and other things that come as being part of the wider CNCF family. And I think, wrapping the news for this month, a couple of things relating to container registries. First up, GitHub announced the public beta of their new GitHub container registry. And last but not least, Docker announced new policies and restrictions around storing images in Docker Hub. And that rounds the news highlights from this month. Okay, a couple of closer inspections in this month's deeper dive section. Obviously, we'll take a look at Kubernetes 1.19, but I also want us to review the changes to Docker Hub usage, because I think it has the potential to impact a lot of us. So first up, Kubernetes 1.19. Now, like I hinted at the start, this has been a long time coming. In fact, the interval between 1.18 and 1.19 is the longest ever between two Kubernetes versions. Obviously, that's down to the global pandemic, but it means we'll probably only see three Kubernetes releases this year, not the usual four. However, for me, this one is packed full of good stuff. So first up, I think actually, a couple of policy things rather than features. So as of Kubernetes 1.20, which will be the next version, new beta features will have a 9-month window to either release more beta versions or go GA. If they don't, they'll be deprecated, simple as that, or at least that's the plan. Now, the obvious aim here is to stop features reaching beta and then just stagnating. The big example being Ingress, which was in beta for 5 of the longest and slowest years on record. That's right, 5 years in beta. Now, I think the root of the issue is that beta features are enabled by default and they promise not to have any breaking changes when they go GA. So all of the developer incentive is to get features into beta where they're enabled by default and being used, and then there's not actually a lot pushing the developers to get them over the line into GA. Well, hopefully this new 9-month policy will help with that. Another related feature, at least, is deprecation warnings. So features get a lot of use, but they're continually evolving and being tweaked. And occasionally features get deprecated. Only, how do you know which of the core features that you're using are on the deprecation list? Well, going forward, anytime you use a feature that is slated for deprecation, you're gonna get a clear warning. Oh, and all new Kubernetes versions as of now going forward will get a full year of support instead of just 9 months. Now, while this is a long way short of something like a proper long-term stable or LTS, I do think it is a positive move in the right direction. Anyway, onto the more technical stuff. And the highlights for me are 3 alpha features relating to storage. We are getting generic ephemeral volumes, CSI volume health monitoring, and storage capacity tracking. Now, I get that these are all alpha features, but the improvements to how Kubernetes deals with persistent storage requirements and how it integrates with external storage systems are just yet more signs of project maturity and the overall fitness of Kubernetes for enterprise-grade production applications. Now, look, of course, it's a big release and there are loads more, but those are my highlights from Kubernetes 1.19. Time for a quick mention of some changes that Docker Inc. are making to how images are stored on Docker Hub, in particular, how long you can store them for. Now, obviously, Docker Hub is the most popular place to store container images. In fact, they've said they've got over 15 petabytes worth of images under management, which is amazing, but as you'd expect, a large chunk of that is junk that's just been thrown on there and then forgotten about. Well, as of November this year, any images stored in the free tier of Docker Hub will be slated for deletion if they've not been pushed or pulled for 6 months. So, if you've got images on Docker Hub and you're not on a paid plan and you're keeping images that you never use, Docker is gonna delete them. And personally, I don't blame them. I mean, I'm an absolute disgrace when it comes to putting junk on there and totally forgetting about it. So I say, good on Docker. And as for you and me, we've been warned. Okay, guru of the month. Well, last month I asked how traffic flowed into a Kubernetes cluster via a load balancer service. And the answer I was looking for was B. Traffic hits the internet-facing load balancer, is directed to a cluster node on a node port, then to a cluster IP, and eventually to pods. Now, I'll hold my hand up and I'll say, I didn't word the answers very well and that led to some confusion. My bad, I apologize. Nevertheless, our winner this month is Kasun Rajapakse, a systems engineer from Colombo in Sri Lanka. So, nice one, Kasun, you'll be getting a goodie bag. This week's question is in the forum link below. Don't be afraid to challenge yourself. And I'll see you all again next month. Same cube time, same cube place.